is a prerequisite for the IAQ installation, and hence we are installing Java.
I'm so sorry.
So Ayushi, that previous version was already installed on your system or you installed some time back?
No, it was already there. Actually, we recently got this new laptop. Our laptop is just replaced, got replaced this weekend only.
Okay, okay.
Yep.
It should not take
this much time. That's what I'm thinking. It's just a Java application.
There should not be any internet issue in this because some system issues there. Internet is not playing any role over here. Okay. Close it and give a try once again. Close this Java.
Well, it's not looking great out. You can minimize this.
From the taskbar, right click and close. Yeah. Okay, one minute. Java is successfully installed. Close it. Go to your C drive.
It's there.
Shall I
open it?
Yeah, open it. Okay. Actually, JDK and JRE versions should be same because you were already having JRE. That's why there is a mismatch in the version between the two. Okay. Let's hold on for this Java part and we'll proceed further. And if in case there is any issues, then we will look up. You can go ahead with the application server now from the installers.
Okay.
Yes, Apache Tomcat.
I just hope this gets installed because I'm not really sure. Everything should be checked in?
That's fine. By default, what it is showing is fine.
Do I need to put anything here?
No need. Nothing. That's fine. No. Java. Okay, go back to one step. C program files Java JRE 1.8.0 281. It is taking JRE. It is taking JRE of the latest version that you have. And JDK version is different, so it may create compatibility issues later on. Okay, click next and Yeah, install it.
Is it saying 13?
Okay. 13 MB.
MB. Okay. Okay. Done.
Close this release notes. Tomcat is done. And next is the database, MySQL.
Uncle, I won't be in any kind of trouble though, right?
See if there is any restrictions in your organization, they may come back to you asking to justify why you have downloaded this software. Then you have to justify. That's it.
Okay. Do I need to upgrade this? No.
No. Yeah. Developer default. Next. Execute. Click on execute.
Okay.
This may take overall 10-15 minutes for the complete installation. Amit, are you done with the download?
Yeah, download is about some few KBs are left.
Okay, yeah. Next. Let me know. Yes, next. Yes. Execute.
Okay, so why are we getting these exclamatory mark and error sample and example?
At this time, it is installing, downloading, and installing. So, if in case of net slow network or any latency,
not that it is rejecting it, nothing
it
like
is
that.
Not. It is allowing you to try again. Yeah.
Why is it failed?
Scroll up and see what is the status of above. SQL Server failed. Workbench failed. Most of the things are failed. Okay, no problem. Click on next. Finish. Now click on this installer again.
This SQL installer?
Yeah, right. No. Click on add on the, from the right. MySQL servers plus sign is there. Again, plus sign. 5.7 plus sign.
Shall I move it here?
Yeah, move it. Click on the plus sign over here. Yeah. X86. No, not in 1 minute. X64. Okay, click on next. Execute. Next. Next.
Standalone. Next.
Next. Set the password. Set the password as root. Means you can set it anything, but for
like default is
easy. Root. Yeah. Root. You can set in
lowercase.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah, next. Next.
Execute.
Yeah, click on finish. MySQL server is installed now.
Okay, and what about the errors that we got earlier?
Because we got the error for server as well. So we installed it manually once again. So it's fine now. And there is one more tool that is MySQL Workbench that we should also install apart from this. So
once you shall I click on next?
Next. Finish. Okay. Click on add button again. Applications. MySQL Workbench, first one. Workbench 8.0, first one. Yes.
Yes, uncle. Folder is ready.
Okay.
So I need to prepare the workstation for that. Workstation.
Yes. Can you check if you have Java installed in your local system?
Okay.
Shall I finish?
Finish.
Which version?
Java 1.8 or something. It's not mandatory to have any specific version, but yeah, one of the latest version. You can click on local instance MySQL 57. Yeah. Enter your password.
Java is not here.
Java is not. Okay. So Ayushi, you are done almost around 50% of the basic installation part. Yeah. So you can close this. Till now, what we have done is we have the application server installed, we have database also available. Now what we have to do is, on top of application server, we have to host our application, that is IIQ. For this, what we will do is, we will go to Tomcat, and which will be available under C, program files, and then Apache. First, Apache Software Foundation, Tomcat. Okay, whenever we host any application under this application server under Tomcat, we have to go inside web apps. Web apps holds all the application that is hosted inside Tomcat. So here we have to host IIQ. So what we will do is, we will create one folder, new folder. Yeah. With the name identity IQ. You can make it in lowercase, identity IQ, without space.
That's it?
Okay. Yeah. Now you can open this folder. This is an empty folder. And here we have to keep the installer. So you can open this window and open another window where I have provided you the IIQ installer. Go back to one folder. Identity IQ 8.0. There is a war file available. Copy that war file, identity IQ .war. Last one inside in this only.
Oh.
Yeah, last one. Copy it and paste it in that empty folder. Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is the war file which is containing all the required files of IIQ for the installation purpose. Okay, so what we have to do is, we have to extract this WAR file. There are various ways to extract it. And one way is to open command prompt and run one command. So please open command prompt and go to this particular location. You can copy that location.
Have you sent it in chat or?
No, no. The location is with you only. Where you have pasted your workflow? Yes. So run right cd space, and then copy.
Okay.
You have to change the directory. Enter. Okay, so you are at that particular path where you have placed the identityiq.var file. So what you have to do is you have to extract this var file, because this var file contains various files and folders. So what you have to do is you have to run the command, that is jar space jar in lowercase.
Just beside this only?
Yes. Space hyphen. Dash XVF.
XVF.
Yeah, extract var file it means. XVF space identityiq.var. You will press tab. It should come.
Identity?
Press tab button. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So here with this command, you are going to extract the var file. Okay.
Should I press enter now?
Yeah. Jar is not recognized as an internal or external command, which means Java is not properly mapped the class variables. Okay. Your system is not recognizing the jar command. So what you have to do is go to your My Computer, and you have in your desktop this PC. Right click on that. Yeah. Go to Properties. Advanced System Settings. Environment Variables. And from the bottom section, System Variables, click on Path.
This
double
one?
Click it. Yeah, double click it. And here you have to add new. And here you have to mention the JDK path. Path of JDK. Go to your C program files and copy that path. JDK bin, path till bin.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Open, close this command prompt and open it again.
So after again, go through the entire thing, right?
Yeah, you have to go to that place.
So the var file was
there in C program files. Not this. This is the place which I provided you. But you have to go under Tomcat. You have placed under Tomcat. C program files. Apache. Tomcat web apps. Identity IQ. Yes. CD space and then this one. Jar space hyphen XVF space identityiq.var. Enter.
Okay.
Our file is getting extracted. You can see on your back screen as well. And you will notice that the file is getting extracted. You will see a lot of files there. All these files and folders are required for IIQ installation. This way we are hosting IIQ on top of Tomcat server. Okay. So now we have Identity IQ folder ready with us. But we do have database as well. But that is a normal database installation that we have done. We have not created the database for Identity IQ. So in under Identity IQ, there will be some SQL query scripts. Okay. So the scripts that will help us to create the database for IIQ. So we will go at that place.
Uses?
You can minimize this.
Okay.
Inside identity IQ folder, you have web apps. Under web apps, identity IQ, you have web INF. Just press W and you will get it. Web INF. Under this, you have database folder, right? So in this database folder, and with the help of this, what you have to do is you have to create the database. Okay. And for creating the database, there is one script that you will see. Create identity IQ tables 8.0.mysql. Because any person may use MySQL, DB2, Oracle, or on the basis of our database, we have to run the script. So we are using MySQL. So we will use this second script. Okay.
Yeah.
And for this, we have to open the MySQL client. So from the search box, write MySQL in your system.
Here?
Not here, on the bottom taskbar, search box. MySQL. Is it giving you MySQL client? Write client only on the search box and see if it is giving you. Yeah, MySQL 5.7 command line client.
Okay.
Not this one. Close this. Yeah, first one. Command line client. Please close this. Please close this. This is wrong. It is having Unicode in there. You need not to open that part which is having Unicode. Okay.
This one?
Yeah, this one you have to open.
Root.
This is the MySQL client, yes. So you have to enter root as the password for the database. So MySQL is open for you. What is your next indication is to run that script that you got from the IIQ folder. What this script will do, it will create a database for you. And before running the database, let me show you what is currently available in your database. Go to your workbench. In the back screen, you have workbench already open. Okay. Here, go to query one on the, query one is written, not query, query one. On the center, where there is administration written in the blue on the center.
Okay.
Right, show databases. This is the query to get all the databases, show space databases.
Databases. Will be another S, okay.
Select this and click on the button which is just above S. Show databases. To the left. Yeah, one more left. Yes,
okay.
This button. This is used to execute the query.
Click what on. Is this called as this button?
For executing the queries.
Okay.
It is showing you the database. So these are the general database, out-of-the-box database, which are available in MySQL. Okay. This will be available for any person who is installing MySQL database. But here you will add one more database for you, that is a IIQ database. And for this, you were running your query in MySQL.
Shall I open that screen?
Yeah, MySQL client.
Okay,
here you have to, first of all, go to that path. And the path is on your back screen, till database. Okay. Copy this path. Under MySQL, there is one source command that you have to write. So in the starting, you have to enter the source, S-O-U-R-C, in lowercase, space, and the complete path that you have, and then slash once again. And the file name that you have to run. Go back to your back screen and copy that name only, that script name that you have to run.
Mm-hmm. This entire thing till
entire, yeah.
Paste it here.
Yes. So this what this will do, it will help to create a database along with the various tables which are required. So you just hit enter. It is showing query okay, which means it is creating the database and creating some tables for you.
And this will show in Workbench?
Yes. After the completion of these commands, it will show a database, new database in the Workbench.
Okay.